Okay, so as all of you know, Super Smash Bros. 4 for the 3DS has come out in Japan early, and people in the States are already buying 3DS imported from Japan just to play the game, or you've already had a 3DS imported from Japan. Well, anyway, there's a little trouble in Paradise with a Miss Princess Peach being banned in Floor Glory matches because of her turnips, as it seems. Because her turnips are displayed as an item, and that's why in the Floor Glory matches that she's being banned. While other players are confused about this because they're saying, well, why not Link or Ness or anybody else? Well, my theory is that Princess Peach, her turnips are randomly generated in different spots in different area, and so are all the other items like assist trophies, home run bats, the golden hammer, and even the smash balls are randomly generated inside each board. So that might be the factor, but how come this wasn't fixed or tested in the netcode in the delay and netcode sessions of, you know, the build of Super Smash Brothers? And this might be a small problem, but this can affect more characters as the game is being played throughout the gap between the Japan release and the US release. Now, this might be a small problem. They can fix this, you know, they can have that randomly generated set in Peach's animation or whatever. They can fix that to where it's just a set animation and not just randomly generated. Or they could just have a whole new process and just kind of like differentiate the two. But, you know, so far, that's the only problem I'm seeing. There are some slowdowns in online matches, but it's miles better than what you got in Brawl. Brawl, it took you a day to find somebody to play against, and the connection was slow. And there's not really any servers for the Brawl, you know, 3DS, you know? It's kind of like your connection versus my connection. And it depends on whose connection was better that you got a really good experience for each match. So that kind of depends right there. So the online is better. There's been some problems, but not too much. And everybody's really enjoying the game. Now I'm going to talk about some leaks here. Let's, I can check this out for a second. Duck Hunt Dog has been released and leaked. Bowser Jr. And no Ice Climbers. Now apparently Sakurai said in an article that the popularity for Ice Climbers has not been high at all, so that's why he kind of just shooed him away from the sequel. Not a lot of people, you know, really liked the Ice Climbers or played the Ice Climbers that much. There was too much codependency on the male character. One of the female character left the stage and the male character was still in the game, but they couldn't double jump and just nonsense like that. And, you know, they haven't really made an Ice Climbers game in like over 20-something years, so that kind of went down. Bowser Jr., Dr. Mario, and Jigglypuff is back. Now, Dr. Mario, I thought was kind of lazy, kind of a last-minute thing. You know, I really don't agree with this add-in. They could have added my man Isaac from Golden Sun, you know, or just other characters that deserve the spot. Dr. Mario feels like a waste. It feels like, you know, a cheap throw-in just to add a few more characters in. I'm glad Jigglypuff is back. Bowser Jr. and Duck Hunt Dog is what I'm really, really psyched to see. Because I've been saying from the beginning that this new Super Smash Bros. Title is basically old versus new. As in old characters from the past and arcades and old NES games versus new characters and new sagas and new titles and new series like the Fire Emblem series and everything else. So you're seeing the Pac-Man versus, you know, Ike, or Sonic versus Mario, and Game & Watch, and even Rob is back, but he's kind of like the default robot, you know, character that's being used as like computer-generated polygons back in the old 64 and the Melee days. So that's kind of what they're doing with these characters. I'm kind of really interested to see, because I did see Duck Hunt's Dog's Final Smash, which is kind of like a sunset shootout kind of thing, like a Western-style shootout. And Bowser Jr., I don't know too much about his moveset, but it looks really interesting. He kind of has like an Eggman thing going on with like his little egg carrier and stuff. So there'll be some more details and more videos on his gameplay as we go further along through the month of September. Alright guys, thank you for hearing me ranting on about, you know, what's going on in the new Super Smash Brothers. And, you know, it's kind of weird that Peach is being banned. Hopefully they fix that. No, because I know a lot of Peach users. You know, I'm glad there's more female characters in the Smash universe. Let's get some more in there. And you guys have a good one, man. Thank you for supporting me. I'm up to 50 subs right now. Thanks a lot. I appreciate it. You you guys have a good day. Cafe au lait. Peace out. I'm back on the attack, load of dust. Take track, burn out rising. Let me go again, I'm in the rising. You gotta take the chance, open it up for the play. Hold up, you better make a name. Hold your combo, take another chain. Call me, he gets bored, cause I'm all in the game. You don't wanna mess with the best, baby. Skills are crazy, you gotta come and face me. Put your boy down, don't take me. Lowest of the blows, can't ever face me.